chote utataka nitakupa ma.
Welcome back to our channel, it's your girlfriend Nilungu back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. They suggested I react to drawers and protection from any disease. A big shout out to everyone that has subscribed to our channel so far. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, and everything. We're very grateful. I hope you guys are doing all right, and may you stay blessed. And a big shout out to the person that suggested this video. Also, feel free to follow us on our social media, Fanny and Jesse on Facebook, Fanny and Jesse on Instagram. And just have fun with the content that we put out there. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
I love you, Allah.
Number one, stay away from haram. You yourself. Staying away from haram will keep all these diseases, catastrophes, calamities away from you. As a protection, Allah, Rasulullah said, احفظ الله يحفظك. Be mindful of Allah, Allah will protect you. Be mindful of Allah in your salat. Be mindful of Allah in your zakat. Be mindful of Allah in the treatment of your spouse. Be mindful of Allah in the way you do business. Be mindful of Allah in every aspect in your life, and Allah will protect you. Second, the dua. Powerful. Wallahi, the strongest weapon we have, and we are not really using it properly. And it's so simple, but we are so lazy, akhwan. Listen to this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. Three times in the morning, three times in the evening. Protection the whole day. بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. Three times in the morning, three times in the evening. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, for example, for all the brothers who travel, he said, whomsoever land in a place, and he says, أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. Once, no harm will take until he leaves. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. I seek refuge with Allah, with his perfect words, from everything that he created, all the evil that is taking place. Third, which is very important, I gave a talk about it a few months ago. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجذام ومن سيء الأسقام. This is specifically for corona, cancer, mad cow, swine, you name it. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, he used to seek refuge from leprosy, from madness, from discoloration in the skin, and the last part is our دليل. سيء الأسقام, the evil diseases. Ya Allah, keep all the evil diseases away from me. Fourth, subhanallah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من استضح بسبعي ثمرات عجوة لم يضره ذلك اليوم سم ولا سحر. Whomsoever have seven dates in the morning. Now Rasulullah sallam specified عجوة from the Medina. But the ulama of our time, he said that any kind of dates inshaAllah ta'ala will do. Any seven dates in the morning, no poison, no sihr, يعني, no harm will take place to that, will happen to that person during the whole day. Seven dates in the morning. Prescription from the doctor of this ummah. Subhanallah. Look how easy it is. قل هو الله أحد. قل أعوذ برب الفلق. قل أعوذ برب الناس. Three times in the morning, three times in the evening. What happened, Ya Rasulullah? تَكْفِيكَ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. تَكْفِيكَ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Protect you from everything. Suffice you from everything. Everything. Allahu Akbar, Ya Akhwan. When we finish the Fajr, we run and we leave. You can do it while you're driving your kids to school, going to work, Alhamdulillah, but do it. And keep in mind, who is the one who has prescribed this? The one who is بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رؤوف الرحيم. One more thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah will not punish them as long as you are in with them. between them, Ya Muhammad, among them. Now Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is not among us. What's the next option? Allah will not punish them if they're constantly making istighfar. Istighfar, Ya Akhwan. Istighfarullah, Istighfarullah al-Azim, Istighfarullah al-Azim. Constant istighfar. And finally, subhanAllah, if this something like this happened, it comes to the United States, it comes to us, and we took by all the means, there's any precaution by the government, by the county, we took care, we abide by it and we apply it. Keep in mind that no matter how bad is the calamity, you say to yourself, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, that the calamity is not in my deen. Ya Akhwan, if you die in ta'un, if you die in such a major disease, inshaAllah ta'ala, you will be considered the shaheed. But if you die that and you do not pray, that's a calamity. If you die, you have doubt in Allah, that's a calamity. If you die and you have any kind of doubt in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's a musibah. That is the real musibah. So Ya Akhwan, when we hear all these things are happening and they are spreading and the outbreak and all that, as believers, to summarize, we take by the means, we take whatever is prescribed, but our hearts have no doubt that is always khair. Anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings, always khair. There's always khair in it. Always khair.
Do you guys practice any of the steps mentioned in this video? I'd love to generalize my answer and say, whatever the situation, we should always put God first. Even in prayer, let's first be thankful. Sometimes you just have to be thankful and not constantly ask for things. Just acknowledge God. God is what I'm trying to say. Acknowledge God and then everything else follows. Whether you're fasting, whether you're praying, whether you're asking for forgiveness, whether you're asking for something, whether you're praying for someone else, all those things follow after once you acknowledge God. The most important thing above everything is acknowledging God, thanking God, and just asking God for guidance in this world that's full of distractions, and asking that we're kept from all these distractions in the world. Let me know what you guys actually think about the protection from the diseases that are out there. I mean, God protects us from many things, from diseases, people, bad energy, all sorts of things in life. But let me know what you guys think about this video and how you go about certain things in life. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.